mortal sin. You have to do that if you want to achieve the kingdom of God. The second degree is to avoid deliberate venial sins, those lesser type of sins, like maybe playing the guilty game of gossip, those little outbursts of impatience and anger. And don't ever adopt the attitude that it's just the venial sin. Cardinal Newman would say, after mortal sin, the greatest evil in the world is venial sin. And if by way of impossibility you commit one venial sin and thereby save the whole world, you would not be permitted to do it because it gives no glory to God. It's a violation of God's law. And the third degree of penance is to ascribe to those beautiful works of what we call supererogation. They are over and above. They don't find under pain of mortal sin. They do not find under pain of venial sin. It's to give glory to God and make the sacrifices that He calls upon. Maybe like going to daily mass, at least a few times each week, if you have the strength, the time, and the help to do it. That's what our God wants from us. And really, through all of this process, fasting from sin, keeping your focus on Jesus crucified. Notice, He's nailed just to one side of that cross. The other side is for you, for me. A cross without Christ is a curse. A cross with Christ is a blessing. That's what we're looking for here too. Blessing, those words of good spoken over you and me. Until we hear the final ones, come you blessed, possess the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world, because you did take up your cross and you followed me. This is what you're saying today when you profess these beautiful promises to the ideals of St. Francis. You're going to take up your cross and follow. I slipped his fingers. I escaped his feet. I ran and hid. For him I feared to meet. One day I passed him fettered on a tree. He turned and looked and beckoned me. Neither by speech nor strength could he prevail. Each hand and foot was pinioned by a nail. He could not run or clasp me if he tried. But with his eyes, he bade me reach his side. For pity's sake, thought I, I'll set you free. Nay, take this cross and follow me. This yoke is easy, this burden light. Not hard or grievous if you wear it tight. And so did I follow him who could not move. An uncaught captive in the hands of love. There he hangs. Pale figure pinned against the wood. God grant that I may love him as I really know I should. I draw a little closer to share that love divine and almost hear him whisper, ah, foolish child of mine, if I should now embrace you, my hands would stain you red. And if I leave to whisper, the thorns would pierce your head. And then I knew in silence that love demands a price. 'Twas then I learned that suffering is but the kiss of Christ.